Good morning, children. Welcome back to the online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Vattakara.
Dear children, good morning. I hope all of you enjoy the Christmas vacation. Happy New Year to everyone. Okay, today's thought. An ounce of patience is worth more than a ton of preaching by Mahatma Gandhi. Now, we can continue our last lesson. Did you remember that? Previous days, which lesson we discuss? Okay, the women caste and reform. And today, I am going to discuss the main points, that is, who could enter the temple and the movements organized by the non-Brahmins, as well as organizing reform and the black slaves and the white planters. Okay. First of all, we can discuss who could enter temple. Before that, did you remember what did we discuss in the previous class? Yes, the previous class we discussed in 18th century the condition of women as well as the caste system existed in our society. And many of the great reformers, they work hard for removing such like evil practices existed in the society. Okay, then here, who could enter temple? You know, who was the father of our constitution? Yes, B.R. Ambedkar. He also faced a lot of discrimination because he belonged to the Dalits community or Mahal community. Clear? Then he was not allowed to enter into the temple. Then in his childhood, he was asked to sit outside the classroom. And he learned from outside the classroom. He did not allow to sit with other upper caste students. But later, he got education and he got fellowship and he went to USA for higher studies. In 1919, he wrote about the upper caste power. He criticized the power enjoyed by the upper caste. And then from 1927 to 1935, he organized many temple entry movement. Then many of the Mahar community members or the Dalit community member, they were the members of this temple entry movement. And the main aim of this movement, that was to realize the caste prejudices existed in the society and to get the freedom or the right to all people to enter into the temple, especially to the Dalits. The next part, that is the non-Brahman movement. In the early 20th century, listen, many of the non-Brahmins, they organized the movement to purify the Indian society. Listen, then after getting the good education as well as the wealth and influence, after getting the good education and wealth and influence, the non-Brahmins, they started many movements and they argued that these upper caste people or the Brahmins, they were the outsiders. They came to India from north and they started to establish their power over the indigenous Indians that were Dalits or the low caste people. Listen, they were the original Dravidians. They argued like that. And one such reformer, that was E.V. Ramaswamy Naikar. He belonged to Tamil Nadu. He was also known as Periyar. Listen, and he belonged to a middle class family and had been an ascetic in his early life. Listen, then he had studied Sanskrit and later he became a member of the Congress. Listen, he joined the INC, but soon after that he resigned from this INC. Why? Because a feast was organized by INC. In that feast, Dalits were asked to sit separately. By seeing that, he resigned from the Congress. So, to fight against such like a system and to dignify the status of the Dalits or the Mahal community, he organized a movement known as the Self-Respect Movement. And he argued that the untouchables, they were the true upholders of the Tamil and the Dravidian culture. And they had been subjugated by the Aryans or the Brahmins. They were the Aryan. They came from north and they subjugated the Dravidians. Okay. Then he felt all religious authorities, They saw social divisions and inequality as given by the God. Then he criticized the Hindu scriptures like the Code of Manu, Bhagavad Gita and Ramayana. Why? Because these texts had been used to establish the superiority of the Brahmins and the domination of men over women. Listen, because of that, he criticized these books. And gradually, the upper caste, they started to rethink. And then some of them, they realized then it was necessary to reform the existing society and to remove the evil practices. Listen, gradually, the upper caste, they started to think by themselves. And they also realized it was necessary to create certain changes in the society. Now, the conclusion part, we can look at that. The influence of the low caste leaders that created lot of changes in the society. Then the Orthodox Hindu society, they also reacted by founding the Sanatan Dharma Sabhas and the Bharat Dharma Mahamandal in North and the Brahmin Sabha in Bengal. Listen, and they uphold the caste distinctions as a cornerstone of Hinduism. Now, the last part, that is, we already discussed some of this part, then organizing for reform. That means to create changes in the society. Many movements were organized by the different leaders. One such like movement, what is that? Brahma Samaj. Brahma Samaj, it was founded in 1928. Who? Yes, Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Listen, and then here, this Brahma Samaj, they prohibited all forms of idolatry and sacrifice and did not allow its members to criticize other religious practice. Another reformer, that was then Henry Vivian D'Arezzo. He organized a movement, that is Young Bengal Movement. He was a teacher at Hindu College in Calcutta. And in 1820s, he promoted radical ideas and encouraged his people to question all the authority. Listen, and the students of this Young Bengal Movement, they attacked the traditional customs and they demanded education for women as well as the freedom of thought and the expression for each and every citizen. Another important personality, that was Swami Vivekananda. He founded the Ramakrishna Mission that was named after his teacher, then Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Listen, and Swami Vivekananda's original name, Narendranath Dutt. And he was also extremely pained at the poverty and the misery of his countrymen. Another reform movement, that was Veda Samaj. It was established in 1864 in Madras, inspired by the Brahma Samaj. Listen, the members of the Veda Samaj, they were inspired by the ideas followed by the Brahma Samaj members. Then worked to abolish the caste distinctions and promote widow remarriage and women's education. And they believed in one God and condemned the superstitious and rituals of Orthodox Hinduism. The important reformer, he belonged to the Muslim community. Then that was Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Listen, he founded the Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College in 1875. Later, it became the Aligarh Muslim University. And he offered the modern education, scientific education and Western education to the Muslims as well as to the Muslim women also. Like this movement organized among the Sikhs also. And one of the movement, that was the Singh Sabha movement. The Singh Sabhas that were formed at Amritsar in 1873 and at Lahore in 1879. Listen, it sought to rid the Sikhism of superstitions, caste distinctions among the Sikhs. And it promoted education among the Sikhs. Now, the last part, that is the slave system existed in Africa. Listen, yes, in USA, especially in the Caribbean colonies, They wanted more workers to do the work in the plantation. But the Europeans, they were not ready to do the work in these areas. Listen, then what did they do? The Europeans, they established their colonies in Caribbean, and so they went to where? They went to Africa and bought the slaves from Africa and packed them and brought them to American Caribbean colonies. And they were treated as slaves. So many leaders, they fought against this. Then after the American Civil War in 1864, the slave system was completely abolished from USA. And the main person who worked behind this, that was one of the famous American president, Abraham Lincoln. I think all of you heard about the definition of democracy given by Abraham Lincoln. What was that? That is democracy of the people, by the people, and for the people. Clear? Okay, I hope all of you understood. Please read the textbook thoroughly, watch the videos, and prepare the notes. Don't forget that. Okay?